Hola, bonjour, merhaba, konnichi, wagwan. Hello. You know who it is, people? It's Arsenal's really, so I want to thank you all for being here. But you know what it is? Believe it or not, we've just gone through a January transfer bindo, people. And it's not a bando window, it's a bindo, bro. It's a mix between the two because it's been another shiesty, stupid window, as per, for Arsenal. But you know what? As you guys saw from the little opening headline, a little picture that you saw, recently Ian Wright has come out and said that obviously Pepe's just started performing. Straight away he starts performing. I mean, obviously, there's a lot more things to talk about in the Villa game, in the Wolves game. There's all sorts of shiesty decisions and weaker players like Soares, players that we should not be competing with, and I'll show you what Ian Wright says about that. But for you to come out now and say, and Ian Wright, basically, you saw the headline, Ian Wright delivers verdict on Nicolas Pepe as Arsenal dealt ridiculous penalty decision. Arsenal legend Ian Wright says, Nicolas Pepe has to do more after the defeat against Aston Villa, during which the Gunners were on the end of what he called a ridiculous penalty decision. Now, I ain't gonna go into Ian Wright's analysis of the game and what he thinks is a penalty and what he thinks ain't, and jumping on Pepe's back 5 minutes after he's just played a decent game. But what I think I like to look at is, it is a January transfer window. We've seemed to forget the fact that since Wenger left, it's gone from Socrates, so we fast forward all the way to Willian. Loans do not count, so we can't talk about Odegaard. But we go from point A to point B, and if you don't remember correctly, at one point, there was a guy on AFTV who called out Joe Willock and said he's not good enough. He was just saying all of this. Ian Wright was happy to get really loud and come out and say to Robbie, don't let that guy back on the AFTV platform again. He's ruining players' confidence. It's not right. But now we fast forward and there's a, you can see, man's got this fucking article that sees, this article will reach the eyes of millions more people than AFTV ever would. So, and I'm not trying to knock Ian Wright. It's his opinion. He's given it. But what I'm trying to say is, how have we gone from this, check this video out.
We seem to be the kind of owner that is investing into a franchise or a club, what I'd like to call it, our club, because he wants sporting achievement. It doesn't seem like that's his goal. And we are in a league, arguably the greatest league in the world. In fact, I think it is the greatest league in the world, where we want to challenge. We want to be up there. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to be at the top of the Premier League. We want to be doing that every week for our fans. And that's what our fans want. That's what we're used to. That's what we've had in the past. And so when you've got an owner like Stan Kroenke, who's literally just regurgitating the money, what's in there to try and buy the players, and without buying those stellar marquee players that people like Abramovich will go out and buy, the Glazers for an American owners, you know, the same with Liverpool's owners. They go, they give their manager money, they give him the capability to buy the players that's going to compete. And I don't believe that we've got an owner that does.
Regurgitate the money. We need the owner to invest. We're not going to compete. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. To then the AFTV moment when you told the player, that guy, not to be bad to Willock and say bad things. And now it's all right to be critical and judgmental. What I'm trying to say is, Ian Wright, along all this way, Ian, yeah, where we got fans that are doing AFTVs and slagging off Joe Willock, and then pundits maybe being critical on Pepe when he's just started performing. But it's well, like my last video, it highlights the same thing. Check this link out. Go and watch it. It's all clickbait. Ian Wright's only doing this for traction, because if you're not, when you wasn't as relevant as you was, Ian, you done this video like I just showed you.
So when you've got an owner like Stan Kroenke, who's literally just regurgitating the money, what's in there.
And you was exactly highlighting the brilliant points. You was really actually talking from the heart and the core of the fan base. Now, for us to go through January transfer window, get absolutely nobody. Villa's got more strength than us. We look at the left back position. Tierney's there, yes. Apart from that, there's nothing. What certified defenders have we gone out and bought from the top shelf? Nothing. Right back, nothing. We went and got Soares in. You look in the middle, we got Elneny, Ceballos on loan, Odegaard on loan. We did up until this point, Ainsley, Willock, it's clearly not enough. You look at the strike force, Aubameyang, the one, we only got him because of the Sanchez scenario and the madness. We needed to replace it. But apart from that, you say there's nothing on that pitch. So you talking about Pepe, when Unai Emery clearly stated he wanted either Fabinho or way before that, and then at that point, he wanted a defender. But he said, if you're forcing me in an attacking mind, don't spend 72 on Pepe. There's fucking, we can drop 42 on Zaha, this and that. That wasn't what was getting said. So my worry is, Ian, like, instead of us highlighting the things that, although they may be true, Pepe did have a bad game, although all these things, you as an opinion, it can't be false, it's your opinion. I don't think it's right for the leaders of this club and the people are held in high regard and the people who get billions and millions of views, like yourself and Rob, to keep highlighting the things that benefit you. It's very easy to come out after a Villa match and say Pepe had a bad game. It's very easy to say Bellerin needs to do better. These are easy things. But at one point, take a look again at the video, a few clips.
We want a challenge. We want to be up there. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League. We want to be at the top of the Premier League. We want to be doing that every week for our fans. And that's what our fans want.
You was talking the truth, bro. So how do we go from point A to point B back to point Stan Kroenke? Because at the end of the day, AFTV, righty, there's a lot of players that, I don't know if it was on, I don't know if it's on purpose, but they're standing on the tip of Kroenke's bell end and they're supporting him right on the end of the bell. And it's no good coming out and creating more energy to say Pepe done bad this and that. It's a January transfer window. Not one person, ex-player, media pundit, fan channel. Nobody's highlighted the fact that Stoke City spent more than us, yeah? No one's, last season, no one's highlighting the fact that our last few purchases, Riddison's in goal, fucking Ryan, fucking Louise, Willian. These are people we're putting on contracts as well. Some of them, Cedric Soares, 4 years, fucking. Are you actually understanding what's taking place before our very eyes? Stop thinking we're doing something at Arsenal. Stop attacking Pepe. Stop attacking Arteta. Stop doing this and understand the rebuild job. Pepe loses company and a couple others. He climbs down the league dramatically. Their squad's still 10 times better than ours. Liverpool lose one defender, Van Dijk, and little one or two other things defensive wise. They soar down the table. Man United lose Fergie. It takes years and years to get back to the top, and it's not a confident back to the top. It's taken £1.6 billion. Let's get it right. So now when we look at Arsenal, let's stop dancing to the tune of right, AFTV and all these ways until they're going to come out with the truth. I don't want to hear Pepe ain't performing, yeah? Do a video on why, start doing headlines about why Arsenal, like you said in this video, check it out.
Yeah, we want to win the league. We want to win the Champions League.
We're competing for the leagues. We want to compete for Champions League. We're going to move from Highbury to the Emirates to compete with Bayern Munich, Barcelona, Madrid. We're going to be good. Wenger's going to get a war chest. It's only going to take one more year. We fast forward. We've reversed the rebuild 3 times. We've sold Sanchez, which in turn gets rid of us all. We give, we don't replace nothing. Right, at the end of the day, there's a reason why Arteta's forced to play teams that don't look as impactful, teams that ain't as creative, because at the end of the day, we've had to get rid of half the team, loan out half the team. There's a rebuild job going on, and at Arsenal, you can't do two at once. We need to self-sustain, which we clearly know. Sell to get money to get in, and to be honest, none of that's to win nothing. It's going to be to climb up the league a little bit, if we're lucky. So, Ian Wright, I don't think you should do videos on Pepe at this moment in time. I honestly think January, February, this area, we need to highlight our owner not investing in our club. That's the biggest thing. It's no point being clickbait merchants. I don't think it's going to get our club anywhere, because let's be real, to come out on whatever it is, the 6th, the 7th of February with a statement like that about Pepe, I have to question what your end game is, bro. What are you doing? Pepe's had the best 3-4 games of his life, bruv, for Arsenal. Don't start cussing him now, but what do I expect? You're an AFTV brother now. You must be. Talk about Kroenke again, like you once did. I would appreciate it. Arsenal would appreciate it. And maybe it'll rub off some of the people around you. Because we need to highlight the issue. And you was a duppy player. You done good things for Arsenal. I know you know the truth because of the video I've shown throughout this. So let's stop talking about Pepe had a bad game when really he's played the best he did. And yeah, it's like a clickbait thing. You don't need no more views or pee or dough, bruv. You got the ting. Go on AFTV whenever you need. But it's time to highlight Kroenke and the lack of investment, and he's just regurgitating the money into Arsenal. Yes, regurgitating. I said it. Make sure you love your people. Make sure your people love you. Yeah, this was just a quick one, people. It's been the January transfer bindo. Yet again, Arsenal fans are fucking deluded, blood.